customer?
Rada Rada.
What? What do you want?
Rada Rada Rada.
A raisin? You want a raisin? I don't have any raisins.
Rada Rada Rada.
What? What? I can't hear you.
Rada Rada.
What? Huh? What?
Honey, is Schnitzel in there?
Yeah, he's here asking for a raise.
You're gonna give it to him?
What are you, crazy?
Rada Rada.
Huh? Huh?
Rada?
I can't hear you. Where are you going? I'm not done ignoring you.
Rada Rada. Rada!
Quit? You can't quit. Who's gonna hire a bum like you?
G'day, cunts, and holy shit. They really did send their best, didn't they? And a long time ago, because, well, it's the same dickheads over and over, isn't it? Last week, of course, we got the 60 Minutes / The Age / White Rose drops, in which we got to see a bunch of local fash exposed. Say bye-bye, job, and friends, and being welcome anywhere that isn't some douchebag's crappy flophouse that you paid for with your membership fees. Today, though, we got a sneak peek into the upcoming 60 Minutes set from this article in The Age, and look, we're back to talking about Sibby, and I know I said I would try and not do vids on him anymore. To that end, I even ignored this alleged music video, which he starts off with a fucking sample from Travis Fimmel playing Ragnar. Ragnar Lothbrok being a historical figure who would have found Jared's bigotry cowardly and stupid, by the way, but whatever. I also said I couldn't promise I wouldn't do another video on him because he might do something else stupid enough to be noteworthy, and predictably, he has. So, what are we talking about today? Well, the same bloke who infiltrated the National Socialist Network, or NSN proper, to get dirt on Sewell and the boys, has spent some time with old mate Jazz as well, and the legend has got Jared on camera doing two notable things. One, he stated categorically that the point of the Proud Boys was to funnel crew further right, specifically to the NSN. And two, he's let his new buddy know that he, Jared Searby, reckons he's up for the NSN leadership now that Sewell is locked away. Too bad, so sad. So, yeah, look, it's no shock to anyone with more than two brain cells to rub together that if there is daylight between the Proud Boys and the neo-Nazis, it's less than a bee's dick's worth. But I love this so much. Like, even when he was with the Proud Boys, Jared was so fucking woeful at the whole plausible deniability thing that they're supposed to be doing. While he was with the Proud Boys, he went on stream saying he doesn't know if he hates Jews. Like, crypto-fascism needs to be cryptic, you fucking Wally. But now, here he is on camera telling some dude explicitly that the point of the PBs was to recruit young boys, because they're all weirdo fucking groomers, into fascism. That's not going to play well for the rhetorical efforts of Proud Boys across the West. So once again, thank you for existing, Jared. We can always rely on you to fuck up on our behalf and push the boundaries of the meaning of cringe to their fucking limit while you do it. Best of all, though, now that he's free from the shackles of McInnes's band of fashlight fucknuts, this monument to rapid aging, the man to be credited with the invention of the subgenre of fascist dad rap, and bloke who's learned everything he knows from his Vikings box set and Fords from his granny, reckons he's going to be the new Führer. And according to the infiltrator guy, he's actually in with a bit of a shot. Well, in light of the above, Jazz, mate, anti-fascists everywhere wholeheartedly support your push. Having you in charge would be a fucking boon. Laters.